off to Ipswich High School for Girls. Usual school stuff. But this is an 18th century building of grade one listed status. So there might just be a piece of that history that we can take back with us. So I'm looking for 18th and early 19th century antiques. Ideally, tables, chairs, lighting.
Today's destination is just south of Ipswich, where the village of Wolverstone overlooks the River Orwell. The monkeys adorning the grand Wolverstone Hall were the emblem of the Berners family, who built the house in 1776. Still considered to be one of the finest examples of Georgian architecture anywhere in Britain, it was taken over by Ipswich High School for Girls 25 years ago. Una Carlin is the current head. Millie Morgan and Nia Bradford are head girls.
It's a brilliant place to be, brilliant place to live, and the girls have got amazing facilities, grounds and everything else to make the most of.
We always appreciate how beautiful it is, especially the drive up. It's just amazing.
You drive up to this amazing neoclassical facade with just dripping with decoration. It is a quintessential British 18th century manor house of just incredible proportions.
Hello.
Hi.
Drew,
how are you doing? Nice to meet you.
Hi.
Hello.
Hi.
Nice
to
meet you.
Well, what a place.
It's amazing.
Can we see some more?
Of course you can.
It's pretty fabulous, isn't it?
A grand establishment like this could be a real test of Drew's astute eye for a hidden gem. But before having a look at what may be for sale, the trio want to show Drew the building's pièce de résistance.
Wow, spectacular room.
Yeah.
Oh, so it's been restored?
Yeah, relatively recent. So it was a summer ago, so a year and a half ago.
Wow.
Yeah. The wallpaper is actually called Wolverston, so it's a Wolverston print based on the original kind of house. So they believe that this was a pattern that was in the original house.
It's pretty spectacular. It's expensive to do it, but it's worth it.
Yeah, makes
it's worth
massive
every
difference.
Penny.
Tucked away behind a large cupboard, there's something just about visible.
The second I look down the side and see, and I can tell at a glance roughly what it is.
Drew climbs in to have a closer look at something big in a chunky wooden frame.
Well?
Oh! I just need to see what it's made of first.
Okay. The moment he has a proper look, he has a shrewd assessment of just what it is and what it might be worth.
Wow.
Really?
Really. It looks like a copy of part of the Elgin Marbles.
Now on display in the British Museum, the Elgin Marbles are a set of sculptures and friezes taken from the Parthenon in Athens by the then British ambassador, Lord Elgin. They're thought to be one of the Western world's greatest cultural artifacts and of pivotal importance in the development of European art. This could be a copy of one small part.
It's got a number in the top right there, which usually denotes a museum.
OK.
So it's come from a museum.
OK.
It's in a nice frame. It's worth a few quid.
OK.
To think we nearly walked past
that's good.
That, Ms. Corbin.
Drew, we're relying on you not ripping us off, though, because we haven't got a clue how much something like that might cost.
I promise I will give you a decent price. I've got to make a profit.
Yeah.
But I'll give you a decent price for it, that's for sure.
What this thing is a plaster mould of a large marble. Now, I think, but I can't guarantee, this is one of the Elgin marbles that's been copied.
That's really, genuinely exciting.
He does seem excited.
I'll sort that out if you want to carry on.
That's
do you want
probably
us to
on
get
wheels.
Some caretakers?
Yeah, he's
asked for
it. You've got two
help?
Big strapping caretakers lying around.
Oh, my God.
Oh, that's really nice.
Look at that.
Yeah.
That's fantastic.
That's amazing.
Yeah, so it's a museum model of a frieze.
Okay.
Well, she's very heavy.
What a great thing.
So what period are we putting that in, do you think?
I'd say it's probably been cast around somewhere between 1900 and 1920. That's been cast from something, and it's a really nice.
It's absolutely beautiful. The frame it's in looks 19th century, the way it's made, the colour, the shape, how thick it is. So all in all, this is a superb piece. Really good.
The panel, which measures 1 metre by 1.4, shows two men on horseback and has been set within a wooden frame. It could be worth around £5,000.
I've got a price in mind of £1,500
okay.
for it. What do you think?
I mean, we didn't know it was there in the first place, so it's a bonus within the day.
I think that's a pretty good deal, to be honest.
Good deal for you, good deal for me.
Yeah.
It's not the sort of thing that's going to work.
I guess we're going to have to let you take it off our hands, to be honest, but it's...
Oh, that's very good.
OK, you've been the first to agree every time. Are we...
Deal.
Yeah?
Deal. I like that, that was great.
Deal.
That's my new one. Yeah, that's fab. What a great thing.
Nice. Yeah. Good.
Well. Wonderful. Very happy. Worth great. Coming.
Good.
Today, I enjoyed it. Came to, again, one of my favourite buildings. This is a 18th century neoclassical, stroke Georgian, manor house of exquisite proportion, and the interior is beautiful. Dealing with Una and the girls was fun, to say the least. Those girls, they are feisty. Smart, intelligent, interesting kids. The large plaster piece, that made the day, really, if not the week. As you learn about antiques and as you go about your career as a dealer, you learn every single day. So you know when something special turns up, and that is special.
Rebecca can't wait to find out more about the plaster cast panel. She's discovered that Lord Elgin was unable to remove all the artworks from the Parthenon, instead taking mouldings, which could then be used to make many copies.
The British Museum twigged on this, and with the moulds from Elgin's collection, they started reproducing quality casts and shipping them all over the world.
Moulds like this were used as teaching aids in the days when copying the great classics was standard practice for art students. The few to survive are very valuable.
I found out that in 2012, 12 casts were sold at a major auction house, and they reached approximately £67,000. So, in theory, we could be looking at £5,000 to £6,000 for this one. It's great news. So the outcome is fantastic. Drew's just going to be thrilled.